JPC Letters. The Romantics and the Industrialists. The Tibetan tells us, amongst many things, in his complete Lucis Trust 1947 letter to arcane school students, that hierarchy were appalled by the inertia and lack of impetus in the period prior to the Industrial Revolution, so much so, that they precipitated stimulus via the fifth ray, thus initiating the onset of the scientific revolution. The long and slow process of the agricultural revolution between 12th, 15th and 19th centuries largely tied laborers to hard lives in poverty and conditions that did nothing for the average worker, other than stagnate their minds and wear out their bodies. Education was largely unknown and the populace were generally illiterate. Landowners controlled the lives and conditions of working people in every respect. The fifth ray hierarchical thrust to improve mental development commenced more perfectly with the incoming fifth racial ray from 1775 with the advent of the more hardline scientific, intellectual age, as compared to the previous centuries of philosophical reason for the few and favored. The mechanical age was foreseen by hierarchy as freeing humanity from certain working and economic limitations. It was however subsequently seen by the masters as having a deleterious effect, being used instead by the fifth-ray industrialists to continue to enslave great portions of humanity it was intended to free. The populace found themselves in great factories working with machinery that made great profits for the owners, and kept the people in poor living and working conditions. There was, according to the Tibetan master Dikay, an influx of souls, it appears from 1770 to 1850, who were the great poets and painters, including writers and musicians, collectively called the Romantics and probably of the fourth ray. These were intended to bring in and stimulate the urge to beauty and spiritual living and conditions, in order to balance and complement the inevitable rise to power of the concrete and material mental faculty. It would appear that the plan was for the fifth ray to be balanced or counteracted by fourth ray souls or monads, at least to some extent. The late 1800 and early 1900 period did see the beginnings of the education of children, though still the emphasis was on early working lives. It has greatly extended, and education today is what hierarchy understands as materialistic lower mind development. Perhaps the greatest advancement was in medicine and the cleaning up of sanitary conditions, which did much to improve the general health of the people. This period of artistic influx was known as the Age of Romanticism. The creative and artistic period did have widespread conditioning effects upon education and culture, as the history books and great paintings and social developments indicate. We are, though, told by the Tibetan that this was, from the hierarchical point of view, a failure, comparative to what had been hoped for. The Great Renaissance ultimately failed to stimulate humanity, and particularly so, the pioneer fifth-ray industrialists, who were intended to implement their inventions for the freeing of, and benefit of, humanity. The fourth-ray souls had come in for a specific purpose, yet yielded to greed and selfishness. The agreed planetary withdrawal of the fifth ray of concrete science would commence after the culmination of World War I and II, from 1950 concluding 2000 AD. The unforeseen and imprecise way in which humanity responded to the rays led the response to the faint impress of the fourth ray of harmony and art, ultimately towards the revival of ancient medieval and mythological tradition, and perhaps as a realism in its extreme, and used in the rise to power of Hitler and the Nazis, who used both these lower ray responses, the fourth and fifth, to their distorted and corrupted extreme. JPC. July 9, 2013.